to me, I'm worth it.
My name is Chrissy Mack. Thank you so much for stopping by. Okay, so today I'm going to show you guys how I made this wig using a sewing machine. Honey, that was a process. Basically teaching myself via watching YouTube videos and knowing how to sew from high school, because that's when my grandma taught me. Honey, this is a process, okay? So if you're new to this whole sewing machine thing, like, I can do a whole super detailed video for you guys, but right now I'm just basically showing you how I did it. It's not necessarily a tutorial, if that makes sense. So I can do an in-depth tutorial, how to thread your machine, what kind of thread to buy, all that kind of stuff. If you guys want to see it, just give me a big thumbs up and leave me a comment down below. If you haven't already, go ahead and hit the subscribe button. It's okay if you don't, but just at least come back and check out my videos and let me know what you think. So yeah, if you want to know how I constructed this wig using Klaiyi hair, I didn't even tell y'all about the hair. I did an in-depth tutorial or in-depth review of the hair. You can look in the cards. I think it's like going to be right here. And check that out. But this is Klaiyi hair in the 20-inch frontal and 3 24-inch bundles. So if you want to know how I constructed this wig using that hair, they're Malaysian straight, by the way, then stay tuned.
Okay, so the hair came in this great box. They sent the hair to me. It came in a few days of them sending it. The great thing about the box is you can store the hair after you make your wig, or if you have other bundles that you want to store, or you don't use all the hair, you can put the hair in the container or the little box that they send. So they sent me 3 bundles of 24 inches that came individually packaged along with the frontal. I think the frontal was actually the same length as the hair, but you know, I'm not really complaining about that. But like I said, use the box, store it. It's good to keep on hand so your wigs don't get messed up. The bundles, they are really thick. I was very surprised because, you know, AliExpress companies like to, you know, try to skim you sometimes, honey. But a Klaiyi hair was not playing. They sent some really good hair, so I think you guys will get your money's worth. All of the packages are labeled with the type of hair that it is, the origin. In this case, it's the Malaysian straight. And if you look at the bottom of the packaging, you'll also see the length, too. If you ever forget, the length will be right there on there. So I just want to show you guys a close-up of the weft. You know how sometimes they have all those little short pieces sticking out? Honey, we're not here for that, okay? Not in 2019, no ma'am. But yeah, the bundles look good and so does the frontal. The frontal is pre-plucked. For those of you who aren't big on plucking, if you look there, you'll see that it's nice and jagged instead of that Barbie straight hairline. Honey, we don't do that around here. The frontal is a 13x4, so you do have that 4 inches of parting space, which is good. So right now I'm going to go in and actually bleach the frontal using the BW powder. I'm using what I have left. I'm just going to show you guys that you really don't need a lot of powder. Like, I know some videos they mix a whole lot of powder and make a lot, but this stuff is not cheap. So I need y'all to save that money and use as little product as possible. And when you start stirring, just keep stirring. Like, that's how you'll make it too watery. If you keep adding stuff, just stir for a while and see what the product actually does. And as you can see, it ended up getting to the consistency that I like. I like a toothpaste like consistency, if that makes sense at all. So right now I like to start from the back of the frontal and work my way forward. To me, the knots in the back of the frontal are harder to bleach because they are thicker, in my opinion. They tie less hair in the front of it to give it that thinner look. So I like to start bleaching from the back. I'm using the thick popsicle stick because why not? To me, it spreads a lot easier. So the first thing I want to do is just get all of the bleach on the frontal. Like I said, working from the back of the frontal all the way to the front. Because like I said, the hairs in the front really don't take as much time to bleach. But you do want to make sure you get bleach on the entire hairline so you don't have those little black knots, because you'll miss a couple of them, but you definitely don't want to miss them in the front of the hairline. Now that I have all of the bleach in, if you look there, you'll see the bleach is just on the bottom of the knots, but I want it to cover the whole knot. So I'm taking that popsicle stick and pushing the bleach into the frontal. You can also do this with a brush, an applicator brush like this. Just really push it in. That's why I like that thick consistency. So even with pushing it in, it's not bleeding. It's not like leaking. If it was too wet, this process wouldn't work at all. So I kind of part the hair and look throughout it to make sure bleach is all over the top of the knot too, not just underneath it. And just keep checking, you know, keep looking back and forth, making sure it's bleeding all the way on top of the knot. Part the frontal all the way through and make sure that the bleach is covering everything, not just in the front, but in the back too, because when you get to parting that thing, honey, you need it to look good from the front all the way to the back, from the booty to the tootie, okay? Now take it, make sure you pick it up and inspect it. That's the only way you're gonna make sure it's right is by looking at it. And then you wanna put some foil over and leave it on there. There's no specific amount of time, just keep checking it. Keep lifting that foil up, honey, looking at it, putting it back, just to make sure it's perfect. Now I washed it off camera with some purple shampoo and then conditioned it, and voila. This is what we have left. Do you see how it just blends in with my skin, honey? Yes, ma'am, that's what we want. We want that blendability. So I use this weaving cap, the deluxe weaving cap. Make sure you use this particular one. And what I'm doing here is placing the frontal onto the weaving cap. Now for whatever reason, this footage got corrupted, but what I do here is I pin the cap in place. And then once I get the cap in the right position, I use T-pins and pin it in place, but then I go in with a silver marker and make lines horizontally where I actually plan to sew the tracks, and I also outline the frontal. I'm about to record another video tonight, or tomorrow night, showing you guys exactly what I mean. I'm so heartbroken that this footage was gone, because it's really important when it comes to sewing the tracks on the frontal, but the way the devil set up, he just don't want me to win. But it's okay, I'm gonna record another video tomorrow night and show you guys exactly what I did there, so sorry about that. Right now I'm going in with my sewing machine and doubling the wefts. This isn't a tutorial, I'm literally just showing y'all what I did. I'm gonna record a tutorial, so don't worry, I'll show you in depth. But I double all of the wefts to kind of cut down on sewing time, because girl, I be trying to slay. I don't have time to sit here and sew all day long, okay? And once I get all the wefts sewn together to double them, I sew the weft onto the cap. You definitely want to take your time with this. Don't worry, we'll take it slow in the next video. I'll give you super, super close-ups and all that good stuff. But yeah, right now I'm just going in and sewing all of the wefts onto the cap on those same lines that I drew on. I know you guys didn't get to see that, but I will definitely show you in a later video. Don't let this edited video fool y'all. This was not an easy process. I've been practicing it for a little while now, so it looks way easier than it is. But when you're first getting started, it is not easy, because you have to troubleshoot a lot. And a lot of that stuff isn't on YouTube. So I definitely plan on doing a series and showing y'all all of the things that they don't show you on YouTube. If you're interested in my nails, that video will be linked in the description bar, if not in the cards. These are press-on nails from Walmart, and I absolutely adore them. So right here, I just want to give you guys a close-up and show you exactly how it looks. See how neat that is? No lumps, no bumps. It's just super neat stitching, and it's so much quicker than sewing by hand, honey. Yes, ma'am. So right now that I have all the weft sewn on, I'm just putting the frontal onto the cap, or onto the mannequin head. That middle T-pin that you're going to see me put in first, that is to secure the frontal in place. The side T-pins that I'm going to put in next, I'm just securing the frontal to the cap. It's not actually going into the mannequin head. And then once I get all those in, I secure the middle of the frontal just to the cap. I take it out of the mannequin head and secure it just to the cap. And the reason I do this is because when I sew it, I don't want the frontal moving around. I go super slow when I do this process. So I pin it in place so I know that the frontal is exactly where I want it to be. Because girlfriend, we can't have that frontal tilting. I'm worth it. It's all on you, so what you wanna do? And if you don't have a clue, not a clue, I'll tell you what to do. Come harder just because I don't like it too soft. I like it a little rough, not too much, but maybe just enough. Check out that stitching, honey. And as you can see, I have the track butted up directly against the frontal, no space in between.
Okay, so that's it for this video. Thank you so much for stopping by and watching. If you're here all the way to the end, thank you so much for hanging out with me all the way. Don't forget to give me a big thumbs up and hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you'll know exactly when I upload videos so you don't have to guess. Other than that, dream big, love hard, make mistakes, but at the end of the day, have no regrets. I'll catch you in the next video. Bye.